Hi everybody, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to do a record checking for a queue in a clinic. So suppose a clinic has a queue and I want to check whether a person is already in the patient record. In order to do this, I create a function to complete my checking task. Let us see how we can make use of the user-defined function to achieve my task. Suppose I have a queue which has a number of patients. I have five patients at the queue. I need one more person. So I have five people on the queue. And according to my patient record, I have a number of people which has already registered as a patient in this clinic. In my settings, I use a dictionary to store the patient information. So this is one piece of information from this dictionary. Tiffany is the key for my piece of information, and the value corresponding to Tiffany is another dictionary. Okay, and in this tiny dictionary, we have two pieces of information. One is this one. This is one key value pair, and this is another key value pair corresponding to this small dictionary. Okay, so for other patients in my record, I have similar details about the patients. Let me do some copy and paste actions to facilitate my data input. Remember to put a comma before we enter another piece of information for my dictionary. For Sabrina, I have the age and weight. And I have one more patient in my record. Okay, I have four key pairs for my patient dict. Okay. So my intention is like this. I want to list out the patients who are already on my patient record. I want to set up a function called printQueue. I can compare the contents in the queue list against the contents of my patient dict. So how can I do that when I have the data structure for my queue and the data structure for my patients? I can create a function to do this. My print kill function will need a list which represents the kill in the clinic and a dictionary which represents the patient record. I can do something like this. I want to pick up every single person on my kill list. And then for the particular person on the queue list, I want to check whether this guy is already present in my patient dict. So I would also loop over the whole dictionary to see if that person is already contained in my patient dictionary. So I would use patient info in dict.items to save the patient and the information pertaining to the patient in the dictionary. If the person contained in the list of the queue is equal to that stored in my patient dictionary, I will do something like this. I will print out the person who is also in my record first. When I get the person, I will also print out the information corresponding to that person, which is already in the patient record. This print bracket bracket is going to print out an empty line so that I can open a new line. I would like to mention that info.items refers to the dictionary stored in the info variable. So info here refers to any one of the value from each key value pair, and since the value is a dictionary, we have to use the info.items method to pick up the age and weight respectively. Okay, so that we can pick up all the records stored in the form of a dictionary when we loop over the contents in the tiny dictionary here. So let us see the outcome. Okay, I can print out the people who are waiting and who are having the record on my patient dict. So I have Tiffany, Raymond and Michelle. Sabrina is in the patient record, but it is not on the queue, so I don't print Sabrina's information. And for Nelson and Polly, these two people are new to my clinic, so I have no information about these two patients, and I don't print these information for these two guys, because I really don't have the information pertaining to these two guys. So my function is able to check the queue, and according to the queue, I can find out the patient record that already stored in my computer. My program is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the most efficient solution to the problem. If you can think about any improvement of my code, feel free to post your improvement on the comment section of this web page. If you like this video, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.